as I make my way to Jerusalem to do my Father's will. I see gathered around me men and women and children and families, all joyfully following me. Some keep a distance, snickering, commenting, and others gather closer. They bring their sick, infirm, blind, and the lame, and they wonder if I will heal them, if I have the power, if I have the love. They bring others to me, but I know sometimes what is more important is that they bring themselves. And though I reach out and heal the blind, it is the blindness of faith that needs to be healed. But we need the courage of men and women who are willing to come forward to touch me. Not bringing somebody else, but bringing themselves. I will continue to make my way. I sense in the crowd a woman who needs to be healed. Come forward, woman, with your pain and suffering, with your abortion, promiscuity, abandonment, your struggles and your sadness. You have tried so many doctors and physicians, and none has worked. And you know that if you reach out and touch the hem of my garment, you will be set free. Woman, don't be afraid. I'm not walking away, but I'm making my way to Jerusalem so that when you leave your hemorrhage upon me, I will be able to nail that hemorrhage to the cross. Come, woman, reach out in your pain, and I will turn around and give you my passion. Reach out in your sadness, and through my suffering, I will offer salvation. Reach out with your hand, and I will give you my spirit. Woman, you know you've touched me, because the Spirit has moved through me. I see you, woman. Below me, cowering, in need of my mercy. It's your faith, woman, that has made you well. It's your love for me, woman, that has healed you. Stand up and look at me. Allow me, woman, to commission you. Go and speak of my mercy. Go tell others of my cloak. Let them come to me for healing. Your faith has freed you. Go, woman, in peace, and be relieved of your suffering.